Hervé Falciani, the black money whistleblower who the Indian government established contact with after NDTV's exclusive interview last month, has been indicted for industrial espionage by the Swiss authorities, who claim he tried to sell secret bank data in 2008 to Lebanon. And Mr. Falciani, who had earlier told NDTV he could help India's black money investigation, spoke from an undisclosed location to NDTV's Nupur Tiwari after his indictment. He said that he had never tried to sell data and that he broke banking secrecy laws to reveal large-scale misconduct. NDTV also spoke to the Swiss authorities, who said sometimes celebrated as a hero abroad, the Franco-Italian national is now to answer for his alleged crimes before a Swiss court. The Swiss Criminal Procedure Code does not exclude the possibility of holding a court trial of an accused person in absentia.
So Switzerland, anyway, right from the beginning, has been saying that this is data and they cannot process any information request from India because of this reason. So in any case, right from the beginning, Switzerland has been saying that Mr. Falciani has stolen data and we will not entertain any requests. So nothing changes on that front. As far as what other countries are doing right now with the same Mr. Falciani, with the same data, Switzerland, as you know, had already issued an international arrest warrant against him, which, as they confirmed to us today, we spoke to Swiss authorities and they told us this international arrest warrant is still valid for him. It has been so for the last many years, since 2009, but that has not prevented countries like Belgium, France and Argentina from going ahead and indicting the bank and using his help in the investigation and his data. So, looking at all of that, it seems that there should be no reason why India getting help from Mr. Falciani for the black money investigation should be a problem. And he said he had no choice but to break banking secrecy. He, of course, says that he hasn't ever tried to sell any data. That is something that he has consistently said. But he said that had there been any whistleblower protection laws, any witness protection laws that would have allowed him to go to the authorities legally and lodge a complaint, he would not have actually needed to break any laws. And he says that this is something that could turn things around for many countries if there are more laws that actually allow insiders to come out openly and complain to authorities when they feel that there is something wrong, that there's some illicit activity going on. In fact, I can quote him to you here. He said that only legal persons, that is companies, etc., protected, and he says, and this is absolutely insane. While you have many countries fighting and suing banks, you have one country, Switzerland, suing individuals like me who are trying to fight impunity. So he, of course, is sticking to his stand that what he did is something that he did out of having no choice. The Swiss authorities, of course, told us that Mr. Falciani had admitted to having developed a database project and that he used fictitious names, etc. And this is something that Mr. Falciani has denied, and he said that to us when we spoke to him earlier.